Hello, I'm Enoch Chen. I'm a PhD student in Epidemiology and Biostatistics at Karolinska Institutet. And we are really happy to invite you, Lisa, among us to talk about the Swedish strategy on education during COVID pandemic. Lisa, can you give a brief introduction of yourself?
Yeah, so my name is Lisa and I'm a master's student in political science at Stockholm University. And last year I had an internship at the Ministry of Education in Stockholm during the COVID pandemic.
We know that during COVID pandemic, Sweden had higher incidence rate and mortality rate than other surrounding countries like Denmark, Finland, and Norway. Mm. But one thing we recognize Sweden did was that they remained the schools open. Mm. They didn't close the school at all. And whereas the surrounding countries, they closed their schools during a certain period of time. Mm. So I would like to ask you about what is your perspective on this, and also why the Swedish government implemented.
Yes, so the reason why the Swedish government decided not to close schools initially was because of the information that we had that the virus did not actually spread as quickly amongst children as in other age groups.
Yes.
And with this information in mind, the government considered it more harmful to close schools regarding the children's academic results and
yes.
also mental health in comparison to the actual risk of increased spread of the virus through having the schools remain open.
Mm-hmm. As an epidemiologist, my work is to estimate the risk and have a better understanding on the dynamics of the disease itself. Mm-hmm. And based on the scientific results, we would love to give suggestions to the policymakers. However, the situation of Sweden sort of reminds me that we not only have to consider the risk of the disease, but also the consequences that the measure we are suggesting that might bring subsequently.
Mm.
So I would like to ask, do you have any suggestion on the interaction between scientists and policymakers?
So going into this pandemic, there was a lot of information going around, and scientists did their very best to figure everything out
exactly.
and see what the risks were and give the best recommendations that they could based upon that. The similar situation is it for policymakers, that the policymakers try to take all the factors into consideration and take the best decision based upon that. Where the scientists, medical scientists, have the task of limiting the spread of the virus,
yes.
the policymakers have so many other factors as well to take into consideration.
Yes.
And when it comes to children's education, it really is a matter of their futures. And we considered that having the schools remain open would be such an important thing. Our education minister said that we know so little about this virus, but we do know for sure how important it is for children to go to school. So that was one of the priorities that were being taken. And more regarding the interaction between scientists and policymakers, I would say it's very important to listen to natural scientists, of course, but it's important to listen to social scientists as well and everything that they have to say about the long-term effects on the society when taking COVID measures.
Thank you very much, Lisa. It's our great honor to have you and to provide different perspectives on school education during the pandemic period. Thank you.
Thank you.